come back with more Final Fantasy 15 character, Manu, Kara. Down a bit. Right, yeah. Perfect doing it. Might be another time. Sorry, I'm still doing that. What I'm gonna do is back on. Get a off here. Good. Be my hang on. Still what it was. Is that any better? I don't know. Probably. Well, Nemani, you come at a good time. I have another task I wish to assign you. The Immortal Flames and the First Blaze have both requested the Guild's assistance in maintaining security at Camp Dryburn, a vital outpost along the Royal Oregon Sunway. The Amaja have been raiding caravans with reckless abandon, creating a significant disruption in trade. Aldar has a long trouble history. The Amaja though raids are not unheard of. However, this recent escalation must be addressed. Go to Camp Drybone and search for these raiders, Nemani. I have already dispatched other gladiators to patrol the region, so I suggest you speak with one for more information. Very well. Since I haven't been there yet, so I have to... Right here. Oh no, not yet. It's just good. Best way to get there is from the morning. Might as well just teleport there. Living God. Do that first. That one done. Now it's time to go east and turn around. I'll probably do them later. Then we use some kind of as well. That's Western. Hmm. after the watch update for Dream Battle. Okay, I'm gonna bring the part. Get down, they're still here. Don't worry, this I'll be fine. Though maybe not when her sword is done with me, eh? Go and tell her that the Amager are dead. Leave the merchant to me. Okay. one in here. Well, two more of them. Oh, this is there. Nope, these two are. Yeah. That should be fine, I think. Hopefully I don't do too much damage. Alright, Western. Western Thailand. Western Western. Okay. Now we can get support to Mala. I knew I was right to send you any money. You have done us proud. Seven Hills, this fair streets are wet. How do you expect a man to concentrate on his field play like this? All this. You remember me? How goes it, brother? Still waving your sword around like a feather duster? Really? You. You. Good to see you too, Mother, my dear. You're more beautiful than I remember. You're alive. Where have you been all these years? Answer me. Me? Well, if you must know, I'm on a spiritual journey of self-discovery. Damn it, Odys. This is serious. We all thought you were dead. And for you to walk in here as though nothing ever happened, have you forgotten how you dishonored us? I should cut you down where you stand. Haha, that's the mind I remember. All fire and brimstone. I knew that pretty face could still contort itself into some terrifying shapes. Oh dear. Don't pout, girl. I'm just having fun. But as you wish, I'll go. The money, was it? Why don't you join me at the quicksand? I could use some company, and I doubt anyone else here would be so kind. Level 7 to 19. Okay. Well, you came. Sorry you had to witness that little reunion between me and Myla. The Sword of Noel back from the dead. You think I'll be greeted by throngs of adoring fans, not threats of violence. Listen to money, you're good with a sword, that's plain to see. But more than that, you've got purpose. There's a fire burning within you. As a former man of conviction, I can recognize a kindred spirit. Geralt named her Frenzy. She's one of the magnificent pale swords that Drunken Prodigy forged to for Colosseum champions. The man who wielded her twin had eyes that burned like yours. The money I. The hells? Ardis, Sword of Nord, we've come for your head. If you do that, then how the hell am I supposed to enjoy my hour? Arrogant fool, prepare to meet your maker. Ain't you a bunch of impatient, humorless fellas? Out for a bit of fun, the money? I'll lead you follow. Okay, this will be fun. Wait, don't I have this on? Didn't think it goes so far as to send the king of Thorfall into the quicksand in broad daylight. Why is it never a bevy of beauties? Let's continue this another time, shall we? I need to find a new place to drink. Some more attractive company than this so lot. Oh dear. My apologies, Namani. I meant to teach you a new technique earlier, but when that idiot arrived, I completely forgot. It's just so infuriating. The shield lob technique will allow you to attack from afar without the need for ranged weaponry. Since three gladiators are primary close range fighters, the ability to draw the attention of distant enemies is a valuable asset. May it serve you well in the field, no money. I've already got that. I'm wearing a level 11. But I didn't need a new love where you got that. And that. So I'm better off with gauntlets. And I got shield love. I won't do the level 21 just yet. So I can put that there. I mean, that's an AoE. That's far away. So. It is not that. Can't find that. Might as well do Jeep with it. The guild highest. Yeah, might as well do that anyway. Admit to me. Now first I'll do Subtoucher. Ready. bad. Yeah, I've got 9,000 that's different than that. Or maybe more. 19,000? Yeah, 19,000. Time for a real dungeon. Hey Kiba, how you doing? And morning to you. So it's evening here, 5 PM. Just got up a little bit ago. So did you have breakfast? Instant noodles. The grind is alright. Just going through the story. I'm just waiting for the dungeon to pop up. So less than 5 minutes. But I doubt it. While it's doing that, I'm gonna come to Horizon. I keep meaning to get back into this. Yeah, I did take a break for a while. Probably about 3 months break.
Thank you.
Kill all the things. Yep. Kill them all. Love that. Not bad. wonder if still I'll still have a cooking going. We can always come back if you wanna. Really? Did not hit. to live right now. Something I'm trying to set when I pass a activity stream Steam overlay keeps popping up and not letting me do it. No, I didn't pass anything. It's just this hitter did not kill me enough. That took way too long. What the overlay thing? I don't know why it kept popping up. Huh. Yeah, it's weird. So I don't have an active sub. Oh. I mean, when did you first sub to Hard Knights for Wayne? When did I first up to it? Yeah. It probably tells you when you first up. 1290 days. I had a level 23, it's not too bad. I was a level 21 when I was in the dungeon. It was only when it first came out. So, same as me then. In 2013. Hunting log, so giant tortoise and floating body. Okay. Hmm. And then go back to 3. As well after. Oh yeah, I'll do that. So that now 100% bit on play. Ooh, I got that as well. I'm not doing anything. Equip. There's a big guy. Well, I'm gonna head out, have fun. Thanks, keep it home by. And you take care. Wait, you need to kill 3 of them? Okay. Wonder if there's any more. Yeah, there's one more here. This one's back. Wait, let's kill him. Sorry, Tortoise. I'm gonna have to kill you. And I'm level 24. And the last one is... I'm here somewhere. Perfect. So that would be... right here. Queen Spit Balloon. Rage of Halone. She is after his right blade. Sentinel to reduce damage. Purple drawn with the AoE. Put that one there. Since I'm gonna replace that with that. Well. I'm slim. There's a barrier and another fire, most knockback and drawing a bit. It also causes slow to the target. There's a 20% chance. Bang. So for 25% of enmity, you start it fight in the first. So that's if we want to swap between tanks. I'm guessing that'd be useful for that. Wait, is there only one trait? And obviously, yeah, I'm not the job. Quest at level 30, I believe. So that'd be a little while yet. Probably do that on the next stream. Probably by then, hopefully. So he's a level 20. Yeah. 20,000 XP. Plus 12,000 on top of that. So upper not that. Upper then we'll see a south grad, we'll get to that later. Put some thing around again. Right, that's where I am. I'll do that another time. Gonna come back here. North ground. From Thunderland. Probably Tinder. Okay. Might as well just, airport. the Burning Wind. Which I believe it goes to the Aftercast. Hi, that player cast was on, but would mind if I unbraid that ship as already now, friend. Might you be the venturer who accepted the job of investigating the pressure? It would seem that the ship has not only sailed, but now returns to harbour, none the worse for its voyage. A pity, we got our boots too long on this one. No matter, they will return and our chance will come. You are right, of course, but there shall be no rest till we have attained our goal, lofty though it may be. Not a wink of sleep, great leader. Our aim, lest you wonder, is to perform such feats of heroism as will earn us a place in the songs of every our house in Eorzea. We mean to write a legend which will inspire adventurers as yet unborn to follow our shining example. Do you have such a goal? Large or small? It matters not. Only have a star to reach for you, and you will reach higher. Purpose can sustain you through times of hardship. Keep your eye on the prize, and all obstacles will be overcome in time. You should not think to stride into battle unclad, would you? Well, goals are as arms and armor for the spirit. I wish you fortune in your endeavors, m'lady. Back then, are you with all your limbs and towers to tell, I wager? Fishbacks, and I was thinking you'd only crack a pirate's skull, all three, seven held. You'd turn your back for 5 bloody minutes, and the scaly bastards set up shop on your bleeding doorstep. Still, sounds like you left them in pieces, so I don't suppose they'd be carrying out whatever mischief they were planning. Unless they was planning on feeding themselves to the Fiona Satasha, of course. Anyway, all was well that ends well. On behalf of Limsa, I thank you for shedding some light on this mystery. You have lived up to your reputation, and I can ask for more than that. Now, I'll bet you're dying for a rest, but just in case you're not, I was wondering if you might be interested in taking another job. It just so happens that I have a request from my sister guild in Gridania, see? Seems the folk in need of a venturer. When can you get things done? What can get the thing done? For them to ask for help like this, you can bet the task won't be no skip through a sunny glade. But after the way you dealt with the fishback infestation, I doubt it's anything you can't handle. Give them a shout when you're ready, and I'll lay it out for you. back to Party Finder. Wait, is there a better job then? Like I said, the request comes from our sister guild in Dania, and that's all I know. But whatever it is you get asked to do, I somehow doubt it poses any peril for a friend to revive the bedlam is Natasha. If you think you might be interested, you'll want to have words with Mother Marine meet counterpart in Gridania. Good luck, lass. Now, I believe this is to unlock the challenge, which is like a weekly thing. So, we do this as well. We all know how it feels to have had one too many. That's why I'll not put off patrons from lack of what goes on our tables. But is it too much to ask that they keep their belongings on their person when they leave? It wouldn't bother me so much if half of them didn't show up a week later and ran in and raving as if their drunken heedlessness were somehow my fault. Take this impressive looking journal right here. As oft used as it seems to be, I've known that its owner is tearing up the town searching for his prized possession. A stranger he was, a swarthy roger who enjoyed his drink, seemed to be getting on well with one of the regulars. Quentin, perhaps you could still catch up with him and spare me a headache. I'd offer you a free drink, but last time I did that, Badron got more wages. Okay, so I've now got to speak with Quentin. He's over here. Have I seen who? Look, just because I spend more nights at the wench than in my own home, doesn't mean I'm mates with every side that comes dumping through the door. Wait a minute, that blade book, why didn't you say so sooner? The tight ass bastard drained 20 dragons and promptly passed out, bearing your tree to cut the bill. Said he was heading for Alport. Aye, where else? The scurvy sop, nearly a willing. He's still stranded at the ferry docks. Though the gods know it won't help get me guild back. Okay, so I got to go to the Fisherman's Guild, get there quicker. If you have business with me, be quick about it. My ferry and my next great thing to wait. My journal. Why? I thought I had lost it forever. Pardon my rudeness, friend. Perhaps I could have stopped after 19 flagons. Ha 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 ha. Did you steal a glance at the its pages perchance? No. A shame that. But this book contains, how might I say it, a record of my numerous adventures, quite the inspiring read, if I do say so myself, which I believe I just did. Haha. You're the air of the adventure about you. If one's still untested, but take heart, even the most accomplished adventurer, and I speak from personal experience, was once a world with more dreams than tents. Were there only some way for me to pay your... But of course, I've a crushed journal right here that might as well have your name on it. Why not keep a record of your own? that one day we might regale each other with stories of our deeds. And with that, I shall be off for adventure and a dragon. All 20 of the realm's finest now calls me. Fare you well on your journey. Next time you find yourself at the wench, do you thank the elves and fellow for your generosity? Ha ha. Patience. So I've now got access to the challenge log. Let's add that. But I won't need these yet. So that's in the lock of being it. Alright. Really, fucking nothing on there. Wait, if I go to dungeon. Right. Okay. Energetic Redania. Take a seat, wherever you like, friend. Oasis will come to take your... Oh. Not here to dine? There, I hope that you're the adventurer Bradron sent right about. You are. The matron be praised. Allow me to introduce myself. And the Caroline Canopy is my place. With regards to the task in question, there is a fair bit to tell. Let me know when you're ready to hear the details and I'll brief you. Why is that wake up? More shame, but that's fine. Huh. Might be because and as long as I'm back in. I don't know why. Ready for that briefing? Good. Now then, here's the long and short of it. Big bottoms from chocolate moon, but are Negroes ever more pressing? Have none stepped forward? And good evening to you too, Bad Lord. Your need must be pressing indeed for you to honour us for a visit. The good news is, your journey hasn't been wasted. I'm pleased to report that we have a volunteer at last, and one who comes highly recommended at that. My thanks for answering the call, friend. My name is Lewin. I lead the men and women of the God's Quiver. Now time is of the essence. So I shall proceed directly to the heart of the matter. We wish for you to nip a painful threat to Gdynia in the bud. Beneath the central crowd, there lies an underground burial site called Temtara Deepra. The place was once a Gimoran settlement, but we Gdynians have long to it dead there. Of late, however, shadowy figures have been seen skulking about the deep cloth, and with ever increasing regularity. Based on the account of various witnesses, we suspect that these individuals belong to the Lambs of Dalmor, a doomsday cult which sprung up prior to the calamity. These sea lots have proven themselves dangerous in the past, and we leave them to their own devices at our peril. Ordinarily, I would have dispatched my best men to secure the deep profit borders to flush the cultists out. Alas, the calamity decimated our ranks, and the limited forces at my disposal are constantly required to keep the Itzel at bay. The birdmen have grown restless of late, and I fear a storm may be brewing. In anticipation of this, I have been compelled to spread our forces throughout the Bosworth, lest we be taken unawares. The situation so being, we must turn to others to deal with the Lambs of Dalmor. Can we rely on you to undertake this task, friend? You have my gratitude. Once you've seen to your preparations, pray make your way to the deep cloth and identify yourself to the guard posted. He will apprise you of the latest developments. That is all. Be careful out there, you hear? May the crystal guide you and keep you. So this will be my next dungeon. Recommendations. So that is going to be an archer and carpenter. Nothing there is anything else. Let's just go into the next area. This might go. There's lots of botanists for a little worker. Pretty much it. Okay then. Go to the central crowd. Right. Unless if you want to go to the residential area. I'll probably do that another time. Here's the little side quest, because I probably won't do it yet. Not until... Probably until I reach level 50. Oh yeah, before I go, I'm gonna return to the... I think we don't unlock the chase project yet. Yes, I'm right up. The rest is boxed over there. I should probably it is then. Yeah, I'm probably gonna restore this ferret. You want the money, Takara? Take it. Thanks for helping us out, friend. No doubt the Bow Lord has already informed you, but your task is to enter the Deep Croft and purge it of the Lambs of Dalamud. In case you're unfamiliar with them, the cult emerged shortly before the calamity put an end to the Crystal Era. The cultists took the Lesser Moon Dalamud for their god, believing that it would deliver them from the devastation. And so they were rather disappointed when Dalamud exploded into a thousand flaming pieces before it could complete its descent. Now, having seen their god turn to ash, one would think that the cultists might feel moved to question their faith. On the contrary, it served only to stoke the flames of their fanaticism. The Lambs of Dalamud are convinced that heretics, that is to say, everyone but them, interfered with the coming of their Lord and Saviour, and that it is now their sacred duty to avenge them. Whatever it is they're doing in Deep Croft, you may be sure that no good will come of it. For the sake of Redania and the Eorzea at large, put an end to their madness. Right. I'll do that. I am going to it took 3 hours to regular repairs. I'm doing one hit. So I've unlocked that as well. Well, this should be fun. waiting for this guy to come back.
Thank you.
And I'm level 26. Nice. Here comes the boss. He summoned me from the foyer to his side within the vessel. I think that's what he did. any of that. Call back the might as well just walk there. But now I'm not the Bridge of Halone. That up there. Back your money. I'm reliably informed that you're parading to the deep cough you say is success. Nor did I expect anything less. Baderon's ring endorsement left me in little doubt as to your capabilities, even so you're to be commended. Baron Lord Lorin asked me to pass on his thanks. I must say, it's something of a relief to be able to call upon such a capable adventurer. Sadly, death has become an ever more common occurrence with an fraternity of late. Time has been what they are, but the guild is constantly inundated with petitions, and we are hard pressed to find enough hands to deal with them all. While this means no shortage of work for able souls such as yourself, it also provides ample opportunity for the inexperienced to overreach themselves with predictable consequences. As if to illustrate the point, these ones over here. Heaven is gone, and it's all your fault. If it hadn't taken you an aid to kill him, he would still be alive. But I tried. He bottled out of rage before I could finish his spell. It should have been so hard pressed in the first place. We should have done more to lighten his burden. But the hell's with this pathetic excuse for a party? I'm leaving, and it'll be too soon if I never see your faces again. Goodbye and good riddance. I'm leaving as well. I doubt this comes as any surprise, but I never liked you. I only suffered you for your healing. But you couldn't even do that one thing right. Poor though this may sound, you brought this upon yourself. Oh, by the way of some parting advice, get rid of Avery's head, bury it, mate it, do whatever the hell you like it, but for God's sake, stop carrying it around, it's just get rid of it, alright? Oh, poor girl. Oh, wait. Don't leave me alone, please. I'm so sorry, Avery. Please, forgive me. I believe we come across her later on in the story. I'm not too sure what it's making. Could be. Well, it might be in this one still. In the realm of Thorn. Things like this have become all too common. It makes a dozen times in half as many days. Now you see why I'm grateful for the adventures you went through. I can send women like you on a mission without worrying that you might not return. Well, not so much at any rate. Speaking of missions, I would entrust you with another. About a bell ago, I received a message from my counterpart in Alder. He seeks the services of a reliable adventurer, and you are nothing if not reliable. If you think you might be interested in this task, say the word and I'll be glad to share the details with you.
Alright.
Since I'll eventually play as a dancer, but level 17 probably won't help for that anyway. This would be better if I'm being a healer, so I better grab that instead. Like this as well. But I'm better off this one if I want to be a healer at some point anyway. So you're not averse to taking a look at wonderful. As I mentioned earlier, the request comes to us from the Adventurers Guild in Eldar. Once you arrive, seek out Grimoldi, the proprietress of the Pitstone. Think of her as the Sultanate's version of myself. Chances are she'll send you in the midst of danger, but I have every confidence that you will pull through unscathed. Now off you go, the money, and good luck. Alright. Going back to the older. Go to the Adventurers Guild. Welcome to the quicksand, friend. I'm a tad busy right now, if you wouldn't mind showing yourself to it. Oh, it's you in the money. And there I was spelt in the same type line. We sent word that you're reporting for duty. He also made a point of calling you the venture at the moment. There ain't no small praise coming from her. But you didn't come all the way here to listen to my prattle. Doubtless you're eager to get started, so let's talk business, shall we? I built that one. Like that as well, is that odd point? Really? I'm better off getting that. The petitioner asks for arriving. God almighty, no second that sun, and I would have been set afire. A tankard of ale, if you would be so kind. Papachan. Isn't time, Papachan. It just so happens the adventurer who will be hanging the petition is here. Oh, why, if it isn't my good friend, Money. It does must be well to know that you are the one who will be helping us. May have you be you'd like to prize the money of our mission? Yes, of course. The petition is in question was submitted by an acquaintance of mine at Amagina and Sons Mineral Concern. It relates to an unfortunate development at Copperbell Mines. To be plain, giants have seized control of the place. These giants are of the clan known as the Hecatoshimir. They're fearsome creatures who were sealed within the deepest depths of the mines during the bygone Horn Dynasty. Alas, it seems they have managed to break through the layer of rock which served to imprison them. And now crowd the tunnels where the miners ply their trade. The creatures are justly angry about their treatment at the hands of our ancestors, and their presence has forced the suspension of all mining activities on the site. It's no wonder they are angry. Didn't the Horn Dynasty come to over 300 years ago? You know your history well, m'lady. The people of that age used the Hecatoshimirs to work their minds by way of enchanted helms. They were able to bind the ferocious creatures to their will, but as is oft the way in such tales, these enchantments eventually failed, and the slaves rose up against their master. In a desperate bid to contain the fury of the Hecatoshimirs, our ancestors induced the collapse of the mine's lowermost levels, so it was that the great giant revolt was ended, buried beneath 100,000 tons of. Well, now that's got me thinking. I seem to recall there being an article about Hothwell in the Mithril Eye a fortnight or so ago. It said the mines were being reopened so as to meet the rising demand for building materials. Like as not, our boys dug a bit too deep and freed the giants. Just to think the poor creatures are still alive and kicking after 3 centuries. That's a long time to nurse a grudge. They must be thieving. Indeed, and that makes them a danger to us all. There will be no mining that Cuffbell so long as they remain. For the sake of both peace and prosperity, they must be subdued. This is a task which we would have to undertake. I will not deny that the mission will be rife with danger, but our need is great, and so I beg you, put an end to the soy business. God bless you, I feared you might have reservations, but I assure you it is for the best. In case you don't know, Copper Mines are in Western Poland. Do take care, you hear? And one last thing before you depart. An employee of Imagine and Sons is presently at Footstand. The fellow's name is Painted Mesa, and he knows Copper Mines well. It may behoove you to seek his counsel. Okay. Looking for a Painted Mesa? You found him. So you're the adventurer who's volunteered to deal with the men standing off bell, are you? You've got guts, miss. I just hope you've got skill to go with them, because things ain't pretty down there. The Hechiteners left the place in a right state, and nearly a week after mining resumed. I don't know if you know this, but Rockwell was old when the second Earl Dynasty was still young, and it was abandoned centuries ago. If it hadn't been for the shortage of materials needed for the rebuilding effort, the concern would never have come to reopen it. We knew full well about the giants beforehand, but the project went ahead anyway. I mean, nothing could possibly survive being buried under mountains worth of 200 years, right? Wrong. Landmines dug up more than they bargained for. One swing of the pickaxe too many, and they found themselves in company of giants. Unless we can subdue them, the nation's glorious recovery will grind to a halt for what one awful to deal with. The same torches were keeping watch over the entrance in case the giants fancy some sunlight and fresh air. One of them will be able to show you the way in. The hope of the nations resting on you, friend. Best of luck. Alright. Time to subdue some giants. What we're gonna do this quest and after I've done the dungeon I will end the stream, take a break, and then continue the stream probably later, if not it'll be tomorrow. It's been an instant in psychopaths. We are here to ensure its effects are contained, but for your own safety, I suggest you stay well away from it. What? You're the adventurer who's haunted for the Hecatus cares? I didn't think that Barbastan would be able to find someone so quickly, if at all. The giants are content to wreak havoc inside the mines from now. But it's only a matter of time before their feet come outside. The sooner you see to them, the better. Make ready as best you can, and interact well. Alright. There we go. And there we go. Dizzy. Brought back to level 28. Not bad. Soon it'll be level 30, and I'm not even on what? First level 17. Yeah, after this quest, we can continue later. The Conqueror of Topwell returns. Prince Theo, our mining operations will be soon, and Eldar will have the material she needs to rebuild. The entire nation's in your debt, friend. I'll share the good tidings with Capricorn next time I see him. For you, you'll want to report to Mamadi. It will do the woman well to see her, you alive and in one piece. Shut your mouth, you thieving little swine. You stole from me. Don't even think to deny it. But please, sir, I didn't steal nothing. I've bought this, pay for it with my own coin. You refugees are all the same. You couldn't afford McAtee mold meat, much less a choice cut of dodo. I'm going to say it one more time, give back the soul, or I'll make you wish you'd never set foot in this town. Otherwise, I should turn you over to the Brass Blades, you know, help keep the streets safe for law-abiding citizens. But I'm a reasonable man. If you agree to serve me in whatever capacity I require, the authorities didn't hear of your crime. Little bastard. But I ain't done nothing wrong. Both as we witness. But please, adventurer, help me. I beg of you. I swear on my mother's grave, I didn't steal nothing. I bought this with the coin I've saved. I only wanted to treat my children to a decent meal. Bunch of assholes. And who the hell are you when you're at home? This dog's master? I've had enough of this mama's face part. You lot teach them a lesson. Well, I can't teach you a lesson. Any more? No? I ain't getting paid enough for this. Hey, where the hell do you think you're going? Thank you, kind adventurer. Thank you for a saver. I swear there were more refugees than when I last looked. And you wouldn't be mistaken. But it's been 5 years since Calamity. Why are they only coming here now? It's simple, really. While a number of hamlets survived the immediate aftermath of Calamity, many were no longer able to support their communities. The residents found their land had either been rendered barren and cut off from trade routes, and problems like those aren't easily solved. Though they tried to make the best of it, it was only a matter of time before they were forced to abandon their homes and seek a new life in the city. I see. But the calamity affected the whole realm. Is the same thing happening in the other cities? If the talk is true, yes. Though perhaps our situation is pronounced. Aldar has a reputation for being prosperous. So it's natural that the refugees would try their luck here first. My heart goes out to them. It surely does. But I would be lying if I said that I wasn't apprehensive. I hope their presence doesn't foment lawlessness in the city. Well, if things do take a turn for the worse, we always have the immortal flames. I dare say the brass blades would welcome their help. The heroes who fought the Guardian Empire, patrolling the streets for Riffraff. It may well come to that. Impoverished and desperate as they are, you may be sure that some of the refugees return to crime. You know what this place is like. If you've no coin, you've no hope. What will become of our city? Not all refugees are bad, thank you. Some are able to find employment and lead honest lives. Dodo tenderloins, get your Dodo tenderloins, guaranteed to be busy in Vanland. Thank you for your custom, madam. Please come again. That was as she bought her Dodo. Looking around, you think that Eldar was well on its way to recovery. But peer through the veil of prosperity and you'll see no end to the misery and suffering. Madame, are you alright? What now? You mean to threaten a defenseless citizen? Yeah, why not? What? Saw her buy that meat, you say? That's absurd. Aye, as did I. Leave the poor woman alone, you damnable butcher. But who said that? Yeah. I will overlook this, but just this once. God bless you, adventurer. If you hadn't come along when you did, who knows what that monster might have done. It don't bear thinking about. All's well that ends well. Yeah, thank you. We meet again. Hey, do not mistake my intent, but it is always honourable. I have been watching you ever since you departed, Alder. You played the part of envoy to perfection, confident as a woman on a diplomatic mission could be, yet unfortunately fortunate for your betters. And when your travels lead you to the midst of danger, you face it without so much as a flinch. Dear my lady, I quite a marvel, and I confess to being quite taken with you. But my lavish praise continues. Most of all, I was struck by your readiness to aid those in need, even when words were all the reward you could expect to receive. Such selfishness is a rare thing in this day and age. All of which led me to conclude that you are indeed the one whom I have been looking for, an adventurer possessed of a very rare set of qualities. To be sure, your rescue of that damsel in distress was more of a happy accident, but rescue her you did, and that is what matters in the end. I feel I should mention at this point that I also harbour a burning interest in a certain talent of yours. I speak of your visions. You have been experiencing visions, have you not? Well, it just so happens that I know a woman who shares the talent and can help you to understand it. She and I belong to the same organisation, and we should both be delighted beyond words if you agree to join our cause. Naturally, there are benefits to being part of such a collective. For one, we should be glad to assist you in realizing your potential as an adventurer. You need not give me your answer. Think upon it, and if you feel moved to help us, as I pray you shall speak with Mamodi, the ever lovely and youthful mistress of the Quicksand. Tell her the signs of the seventh dawn there, woman, and she will tell you where to find us. Time to finish up the quest. I mean, Banfrit, so that'd be... I'm not too sure what server that is. Scenes like that are becoming ever more common, I'm afraid. Don't worry though, you work hard, you'll probably be alright. Saying that, if you ever find yourself in a spot of bother, come and see me. Just don't go pestering me every time you raise your knee, eh? Of course, I do enjoy hearing tale of gentlemen's woes with the woman folk from time to time. Ah, no money. Sorry to keep you waiting. I was just providing guidance to a fresh off the carriage adventurer. By gods, it's good to see you safe and well. To look at you. No one would ever guess you've been hard at it with giants in the dark. I never doubted for a moment that you would lead, of course. I knew it did, Papa Chan, but it's shame to say you won't be overjoyed. Oh, before I forget, there's a lass here who wants a word with you. Didn't actually know your name, but hearing her description, I knew who she meant right away. It's this woman. But thank you for sparing the time. I realise you don't know me, but I've been longing to speak with you for a while now. My name is Edda. I'm an adventurer like you, though I'm not very good at being one, if truth be told. Anyway, I was venturing with my friends in Gridania when the leader of our party was killed. His name was Avery, and he and I were to be wed in the spring. You may not remember him, but to say that he remembered you would be an understatement. He was seeing your poses from dawn to dusk. He saw you for what you are, you see, an adventurer's adventurer, and saw that he would be like you one day. I believe that he would have succeeded had a fiend not robbed him of his charm. Since that day, I have thought long and hard about giving up adventuring. But when I think of the woman you are, of all that you achieved, I find that I am inspired just as Avery once was. And so I've decided to start again as an adventurer. I will go back to the village of my birth and begin my training anew. But I wanted to meet you first to ask you your name. Namani Takara? I shall not forget. Thank you, Nami Takara. I pray that we will meet again. Fare you well. Adventuring can be a cruel, bleeding business. Time was, I didn't know why anyone would bother when they first asked me to take charge of the guild here. I didn't want aught to do with you lot. Thought it'd be right pain in the ass looking after you all. But against my better judgment, I decided to accept the post, and I'm full glad I did. I feel privileged to be part of your lives. And that goes double for yours, the money. What did you say? You want to know about the signs of the seventh dawn? They're beginning to move in earnest. Listen, the money. The signs ain't no ordinary folk, and the work they do ain't no ordinary work. I know full well how careful you are, but even you would think twice about some of the stuff they do. Knowing that, if you're still certain you want to get involved, I'll tell you what I can. Had to be the belt, this one. I'm gonna end the stream here. Thank you for coming by, Eva and Fantastic, is that it? Yeah, I'm in Banquet server or world. Let's see who's on to raid. great video games. He's currently playing Pokemon Emerald. So. There we go. Hey guys.